Always seems to be a struggle. What financial documents do you keep? Which ones do you throw out? Which ones do you keep for how long? Lady's got the answers. Financial expert Kelley Keehn joining us now. And why don't we start with what can we get rid of? Because we do end up with so much stuff.
I know, and I'm renovating right now, and I'm looking through my own stuff saying, what do I do with this? What can you keep? So what we want to look at, if it's anything to do with our taxes, we want to keep that for at least 6 years and any supporting receipts, okay?
Okay, so that's very important because you never know when you could get sort of an audit down the road. You could get your taxes reviewed by Revenue Canada up to 6 years?
Yeah, up to 6 years. So get yourself a little cabinet, something neat and tidy. Everything tax-wise goes in there.
Okay.
So now what can you toss? Now,
is that the only thing we're keeping is taxes?
Well, we're keeping, we're going to keep things like, how about our life insurance?
Life insurance
documents, investment accounts. We don't want to throw those away. Things like scholarships, awards. We want to absolutely keep that. Now, also, we're going to talk about where we should keep these things.
So,
some things that we don't want to file away is our passport. Maybe keep a copy of your driver's license. Things like that. How about really important medications? So that your family knows if there's any emergencies or complications.
And the documentation behind those medications?
Or just even, a copy of them in a place if you're traveling and you need to get a refill.
So you do want to hold on. I guess in some ways it's sort of common sense. Things you might need that you're likely to need down the road, you want to keep and in some kind of a safe place.
Right. But the thing is people keep, I had this one client when I was still in practice and they had a farm. So they kept everything from like the 1950s. Can you imagine that once the kids have to go through that, what a nightmare it's going to be?
That's like financial document hoarding.
Oh,
right?
It's the worst. But a lot of people are fearful. So things like if you go to the ATM and you make a deposit, keep that till you go online and you see the deposit's been posted or you get your little statement in. But you don't have to keep that for years. You don't have to keep that kind of stuff. You don't need your cell phone bills or unless you're self-employed, then you need that.
Oh, okay, because that is something you can claim for your taxes down
That's right, or but maybe a portion of your household, like your direct energy and your EPCOR,
So some of your bills, like how long do you keep those bills for? Because I know that I've been through our filing cabinet and I had that thick of bills from like 7 years ago and I got rid of a bunch of them just before talking to you, but out they went.
It's hard for a lot of people to do that. You don't need to keep them. You don't need to keep your bank statements. Once you've reconciled that, yes, this is correct on your credit card or what have you, you can get rid of it immediately. Just make sure you shred it. Even a TELUS bill. Don't just toss that. If it has your account number on it and your name, don't toss it. Shred it.
Because this is all information that identity thieves can use against you and that kind of thing.
Yeah.
Just on the bills issue, if you are doing claims through your income tax for home businesses, do you need is that like supporting receipts you need to keep for that 6 years?
Yes, good question. So if you're writing off a portion of your mortgage interest, your heating costs, anything of that sort, that becomes part of your support for your tax returns. So yes, all of that 6 years. But if
you're not,
toss it.
Fire it.
Yeah.
You can maybe keep it like for a year so you can compare your heating or gas or
which it actually shows on your bill. It shows that you're if it's gone.
Yeah, but I don't know if I want to trust them. I want to look at my bill
from last year
and make sure that you got that thing handled. That is kind of funny. Do you get a lot of people asking this kind of a question because it seems like such a no man's land for some people. They don't know really what you want to keep and what you don't.
They don't know and they don't know where to keep it. So when it comes to your financial documents, I recommend people have a binder and you have your lawyer's name there, your doctor's name there, your financial planner, what have you. Because what happens when a person passes away, a lot of times the family doesn't even know who to call. Like, do they have an account? Don't they have an account? And then list your accounts as well. You don't have to have the dollar amounts or things of that sort, but where they are. Also, what documents do you have and where are they? Powers of attorney, where's the will, where's the living will?
And you also have redundancy too, because if there's a fire in the house and it's not in a fire safe of some kind, that could all be lost as well. Is it important to make some sort of redundant documents and then put them somewhere, safe deposit box or something like that?
That's a great idea, absolutely. Have a copy in the safety deposit box. Things like wills can stay in the safety deposit box. We don't want to see the power of attorney and the living will in the safety deposit box, because if something happened to, let's say, my mom, and I need to go and prove that I'm a power of attorney, I can't get into her safety deposit box to prove that I'm the power of attorney.
Catch 22.
Or at least let your people know where the safety deposit box key is.
See, she knows what she's talking about. She's actually the author of 7 different books, Kelley Keehn, including the money book for everyone else. You can check out her website, kelleykeehn.com. 7 books so far? When's number 8 coming out?
Not for a while.
Not for a while. You got renos to finish first. Yeah. I forgot about that. Kelley Keehn, always nice to see
Thanks,
you.
Thanks, Gerald.
Thanks.